For a beginner, I'd say first is the gear, helmet, vest, gloves.
Okay. Is there a footwear?
Yeah, Apple shoes is best.
Mahal naman yan eh. Okay, next.
And wetsuit. Yeah. That's like the basic gear. Yeah, helmet and goggles go together. Also, the back support and back protector. That's just for the beginners, but if you're racing, then you need more stuff like the back support, back brace, because they won't allow you if you don't have those during the races. Yeah.
Joyce,
bakit
makakasagot? Kasi may tanong si Tracy na parang how much daw?
How much annually, monthly, like how much?
Tatabi namin.
Well, if you want to buy your ski, you buy the entry level first. Kasi hindi na lang sigurado ko, hindi ko sa talaga ng bata. So that's around, I would say, 1.2 million of that. But,
so sorry for grabbing the mic, but just to let you know, it does sound expensive, but the truth be told, the average racer would be using these equipment, and these equipment would go anywhere from 300 to 500,000 pesos OC. In regards to your question, Conan, it's really based on fuel and your time. You have to drive your car, you have to then put fuel in your ski, and then that's the major expenses, so you just have to count your hours and how many meters to spend, but then it doesn't come out to be so much, especially the good part is quite economical these days. Because the jet ski is now more reliable using a 4-stroke platform versus the 2-stroke before. We have to buy a new engine, but those days are gone. So now it's quite economical. Not even close. Initially, depending what class you race in, if you get a good second-hand boat, you could start off sub 700, 500, and that could be competitive and yet reliable too. And if you meet the right people also in the industry, they could guide you also. There's no specific limits, but there are the champions who you could also, the phone and Zach, that you could come up to. And they'll guide you to do the right thing, wear the right thing, and how to practice. So maybe on a weekly basis, you could be spending, I would say, some 4,000, and that's probably much for your fuel and those are the major expenses besides your meals and besides your time. So that's all you probably need to spend.
Well,
actually, if it's a beginner, like Paul was saying earlier, you start them with a time attack. Hindi pwede beginner sa amin na kagad sa close course racing. In a time attack race, you use one jet ski. The association will provide the jet ski that you will use. Yes, it's not going to be that expensive. Kasi yung program na gusto gawin ng JSAP ngayon, hindi naman natin sigurado kung gusto ka lang ng bata. So we want to introduce them to the sport by doing the time attack, which the association will provide the jet ski for the race, for the time attack race. So, siguro, when you practice, I think that's only about 3,000 to 5,000. Or you can do a rental. And then, yung mga clinics naman, syempre yung mga older generations, as Anton, you would love to pass on the knowledge to these so that we will be creating more good drivers in the future.
Just a follow-up question, because I know one of the trainings Steve and Paul does is like doing weight lifting. So, basically, what do you have
requirement
for your salary?
Yeah.
I mean,
like,
that
gives
us a lot of...
Me, personally, I don't. Yes, I make sure to balance it and not eat too much. We have to work out, Lali.
Mabilis ang metabolism mo.
Yes, yes, yes.
We do a lot of core workouts.
Core, lifting, sometimes cross-training, basketball, boxing. Yeah.
Thank you, Trixie.
Trixie, badminton na lang tayo. 89 lang yata sa TikTok yung isa na kaya tayo.
Please.
Our President Harley David works closely with the POC and he's been working very diligently with the board of JSA. The good news is there is inclusion for 2025 and we're almost going to lose that. All we needed was 5 countries to participate. Now we have Cambodia confirmed, Brunei confirmed, of course Thailand, and we have the Philippines and Malaysia, so Indonesia, of course. So we're all happy that they're there. Now the next step is with the POC and our President Harley, and coordinating with Harley now. Harley's on top of it, and he's fixing his letter of accreditation and his endorsement letter to write back to the POC and for the POC to write back to the International Association. So for SEA Games, I'm still practicing every week, and SEA Games is next year, 2025. So I'm expecting to practice more and have more time on the water.